And as we look at the numbers on the tail of the tape for these gentlemen, one thing that stands out, Nunes is 11 years older than Marshman, and that could be a problem cardio-wise should this match head into the deep water of the second and third round. So let's send it up to the voice of Bama,
ladies and gentlemen, it's now time for our next contest of the evening, and it's for the Lonsdale British middleweight title, sponsored by Lonsdale, the official equipment partner of Bama. And now it's time for 3 5-minute rounds of fighting in the middleweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, this man is a mixed martial arts fighter with a professional record of 7 wins, 1 loss, with 3 wins coming by TKO. He stands 5 feet 10 inches tall and weighed in at 185 pounds from Lancaster, England. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our first challenger, Carney. His opponent fighting out of the blue corner, this man is also a mixed martial arts fighter and is undefeated with a professional record of 8 wins, no losses, with 7 wins coming by TKO. He stands 6 feet tall and weighed in at 185 pounds from Tillery, Wales. Ladies and gentlemen, our second challenger, Jack Hammer Marshman. And when the action begins, your referee for this contest is Mark Woodard.
So the atmosphere has really risen up a notch for this Lonsdale British middleweight title, the first of its kind here at BAMMA. And really, what a great way to start with these two warriors.
I can't wait for this match. This match, in a way, reminds me of a UFC heavyweight title fight between Maurice Smith and Mark Coleman, where you had a really muscle-bound guy like Noon wanting to take down the stand-up fighter, and that will be Marshman in this case.
Yes, both have bought huge fan followings here, and both carry the knockout power. It's Noon that comes forward first with the short chopping leg kick. And you can see the height advantage of Marshman, Stephen.
A real smart game plan by Noon, leading with the overhand right, getting into the body lock. But Marshman resisting well up against the fence.
And as you predicted, it makes common sense when you look and your opponent has 8 wins by KO. You take him down.
And there he is in side control up against the fence. Carl Noon is going to want to use that left elbow to the head of Jack Marshman.
Now for Marshman, Steve, this is where he really doesn't want to be, given that power and the way he fights. With the way Noon is doing this, what's he got to do in response?
Well, Noon really has to get busy here with strikes, but Marshman is going to try and get guard here, or try and get his back up to the fence and crawl back up. The forearm across the throat of Marshman is going to be an annoyance, because all you have to do is turn your head to the side to avoid any kind of problem.
But for you, as you quite rightly predicted, Noon slowly but surely taking his man towards the fence. And this was a tactic really that you predicted, looking at the stats on both men.
Yeah, it makes sense, because you don't want to go up against a two-time boxing champion in the Army, especially a veteran of the Afghan War, and try and trade with him standing up. Starting to drop down from the guard, and Noon is getting busy.
And that's a big man to be dropping bombs on you, but there again, it was an initial attempt there by Marshman for the arm.
Yeah, Marshman was looking at that arm, trying to hyperextend, but Noon countered.
And these are heavy shots coming down, Stephen. Trying times for Jack Marshman, the undefeated fighter, the former soldier. Noon at the moment, we've got to say, doing everything right.
Noon lost his first fight, but technically is undefeated in his last 7. Looks to extend that streak to 8 here with a ground and pound victory.
Yes, it's uncomfortable moments there for Jack Marshman. And these are real bombs landing, Stephen.
Yeah, that right hand is starting to find its mark every time that Noon throws it.
Oh, and We felt that one right above us here. Stephen actually wins the fight professional. He's seen this all over the world, but that was a big shot.
These are huge right hands thrown by Carl Noon. And the problem is, unlike in a boxing match, Jack Marshman has the mat up against the back of his head, so there's no give in those punches at all.
And the right hand, the left hand side of his face, Stephen, already beginning to mark up. There might be a little bit of blood there as well as Noon comes firing in.
This is turning into a one-sided beating.
Has he gone for the arm again?
He's going for the arm bar. Risky move because you leave your face unprotected. And right now, Carl Noon has rarely missed with any of those punches to the head.
Stephen, that left eye is swollen, it's split, it's cut already. And this is not the scenario Jack Marshman's fans thought it would be, because this is a real beatdown. But having said that,
Marshman going for the armbar, and Noon has got to hop over the top and get out of there.
Well, that shows you that still, despite all the beating, the man is still in there, he's still thinking.
Yeah, barely thinking, because he's got to be spinning in his head as well. Every punch that lands doesn't help his cognitive functions, trust me.
One of the things that's impressed me about Carl Noon, he's not got carried away, he's picked his shot still, hasn't he?
That's right, because we've seen so many times when a guy gets on top like this, he'll start missing shots, but almost 90% of these shots are landing.
Yes, they're cold, they're calculating, and they are heavy from Carl Noon. And with a minute left of the round, it's been a totally dominant display by Noon at the moment.
And Noon really content to just stay in the guard and blast away. He was only momentarily bothered by those armbar attempts, but he's got to really make sure he doesn't punch himself out.
Yes, he's done everything right. And that's where I said one thing that has impressed me. He hasn't got carried away with the sight of blood there.
Now we're seeing a slowdown. And that left eye of Marshman is a mess.
And he's crashed down the elbows as well, Steve. Marshman, if he makes it to the end of the round, they're going to have to work hard on him. But, I mean, to be quite honest, Noon has been relentless, hasn't he?
He really has. Now he's using the left hand for a change.
I mean, Marshman at the moment is showing great guts and resilience, but how long will Mark Woodard look at this? He must know it's near the end of the round. And there we have it. Well,
after the punch, but he cocked it before the round was over. A dominant round for Carl Noon.
Now, Stephen, we said how confident and calm Marchman was coming in. It certainly didn't work in his favor. Noon, for me, did everything right.
Yeah, he threw the overhand right. He got the body lock. They worked up against the fence. And then eventually, Noon got on top. Marshman on the floor, side control, and then he just gave up and he just at guard and just blasted away the whole round. That was almost a 10-8 round.
So from what you've seen with this, as you said, a constant beatdown, accurate, he was economical with his punches as well. How does Marshman stop that happening in round two? Because that's all Noon's want to go to. He won't want to change that game plan, will he?
No, he's got to use side-to-side movement. Antonio McKee, who's a great wrestler, told me the way to defeat him is to use side-to-side movement if you're a striker. You don't move straight back. And that was one of the fundamental errors that that man there, Jack Marshman, did. And he got pinned up against the fence and taken down.
Now, Steve, on a positive side, if you can see any, that's a long cut, but they're working well on it. They've stemmed the bleeding. They stopped it, but he's still in there. That is the most important thing with a cut like that. They've stemmed it, they've stopped the bleeding, and he's ready to go again. For me, it's imperative. He's got to keep it on his feet longer.
He really does, because he's not going to win on his back. He had a reasonably good guard game, threw up a couple arm bars, but only one of them was even close.
And looking at the other side of the coin, you must be so impressed with Carl Noon. You predicted, though, what he would do, but did you think he would do it so efficiently?
You know, I really didn't know much about the takedown defense of Mr. Marshman, but now I do. And it's partly that, but it's partly the determination and that conditioning that we talked about earlier of Carl Noon.
The other thing that impressed me about Noon, which you touched upon, is with that muscle mass, cardio, you can easily gas overworking. He picked almost every shot, didn't he?
Yeah, the thing is, the problem with a muscle mass situation like that is the longer the fight goes, the more it's going to become a detriment, especially if they keep standing and it goes in that third round. And then Marshman, if he still can see out of both eyes, he could be a problem for Newell.
Now, we saw his corner check. We know at the moment he can still see out that left eye. But Noon, we know what he's going for again, Steve, and he's trying to work that left eye and then go down for the takedown.
See, the good thing that Noon is doing is rather than just diving in for a takedown, he's diving and punching. So Marshman has to block punches and defend the takedown at the same time, which is not an easy task. That knee is going to be a huge factor in turning the tide, because if Noon ducks his head down low like that, he could get knocked out.
Well, already we've been upright far more in this round than we had in the previous. And a good defense again, a good sport from Marshman. And then the heavy hand. And as he rocks, Stephen.
A totally different round, this one. As you said, Malcolm, it was a beautiful sprawl by Marshman. Now he's playing his game.
And suddenly he's got the respect. Oh, but a nice duck and takedown attempt by Noon. Just in the nick of time for him, as it looked like it was turning away from him.
That's the problem. Sometimes when you load up on that one shot, you leave yourself out there for that extra second, got body locked and taken right down.
Because until that point, you saw light for Marshman. You saw a way back into this fight.
Yeah, Marshman has got a pretty decent bottom game. But the problem is, when you're eating punches, it's really hard to do effective jiu-jitsu. That's just MMA.
He had a short elbow there as well. He's got a time up, hasn't he? And bring him down to at least to make Mark Woodard stand them back up again.
Yeah, he's going to try and lock him up. And Noon is posturing up. That way he can get more velocity into those strikes. Because if he can drop his whole body behind those punches, it's going to be a lot more danger for Marshman to eat those punches.
And a subtle little thump to the body there as well from Noon. Again and again there, Steve. He's working well up and down, isn't he? And this is what I've liked about him, knowing his size and his muscle definition, the economy of what he's doing.
Yeah, I think it's a situation now where, okay, that's a good restart. I mean, there was a lull in the action. Noon actually went to the body one time when he was on top, hovering above Marshman. But now, oh, man. The left side of Marshman's face is starting to swell up as well.
But he is getting through with those punches finally. And again, I pick up on the point you mentioned earlier about the size eventually maybe playing against Carlman.
I love fights like this where it's a stylistic matchup, because these guys are delivering, because there is a potential for a fight like this to have the wrestler just get on top and blanket. Now look at this! Marshman comes alive!
And it's those right hands, Stephen, as you said, it's the first signs of tiredness from the technique in Noon.
Marshman on top, in the mount, in control!
What a turnaround, and he's going to give up his back here. Well, he's going to try to go through the back door, wasn't he? But Marshman's alive to it. And suddenly it's a real turnaround, Steve.
I guess he doesn't like the rear naked choke because he gave up back control. He wants to end this one standing, obviously. And look at that! Carl Noon staggered there. He's getting tired.
This is the problem for him. That's why I'm here with the fight professor. He's called it. He's tiring very quickly now. And he will now be susceptible to the bombs of Marshman.
Yeah, now listen. The body language of Carl Noon is not a good one to be in. Because should he not get Marshman down, he's going to be in big problems for punches and kicks while standing.
And there's a real tiredness to that takedown attempt.
Both men putting everything into this fight.
There's that body language you mentioned, Stephen.
When you put your hands on your knees, you're saying, hey, guess what? I'm fatigued.
Oh, the right hand straight in. But Marshman took an uppercut as well. What a slugfest this is now turning into. But you feel the balance of power with that tiredness.
He just falls down. He's on the verge of being finished here. His gas tank is almost empty, running on fumes.
There's under a minute left, but these are really desperate times for Carl Noon. It's all Marshman out, and look how he just rolled over there.
Marshman has to just relax here, pick his moments, try and get position, and pick his shots. He might want to start throwing elbows, though.
Because his body language, Steve, is saying this is over. Look, he's saying this is over.
This one's really close. And our referee is talking to Noon.
It's got to be intelligent defense. Well, what a second round turnaround. And listen to the response from that turnaround.
It was like a lunar eclipse. You saw the sun 1 minute, and then you saw the other side, the other. And that round was all Jack Marshman.
And let's put it in perspective. You said the one concern for Nunes, when if he didn't put him away like that, the cardio, the gassing, we're seeing the results of that here, aren't we?
Well, we saw the takedown attempt, and that was unfortunately, Nunes getting very sloppy on those takedowns. It's because he's running out of gas.
Well, what a turnaround and what a second round. How can you motivate Nunes for this third round, Stephen? He had a job to get it
back.
Well,
I don't know, but I'll tell you what. After that first round, the corner of Jack Marshman got him motivated because he came out and started slinging. And he won that second round as big as Nunes won the first. So this fight's up for grabs, and Nunes looks in bad shape here. He had to be almost lifted up by his corner man and put on his stool.
So we have had everything we thought we might in this Lonsdale British middleweight title fight, and we are so excited. And Marshman is still there. They've done a great job on his eye. It's swollen, but he's still seeing out of it. And you can feel new confidence in him. And look at Carl Noon.
I think Marshman should not even try and load up. He should just start. There he goes. There he is. There's the knee.
Stephen, if it stays like this, this isn't going to go much longer in this round. It's sheer willpower keeping Noon up at the moment. Here's gas, 100%.
Yeah, this is a situation where a really good boxer is going to know, don't load up until you know you've got the shot. Throw punches and land, because eventually Noon is going to go down on his own volition. Look, he's ready to go down right now. A soccer kick would have ended it right there.
Yes, it's totally turned around now. But like you said, Marshman picking shots. He looks to his corner. I think he's bemused by the way Carl Noone goes down. Like, as you said, there's initiative to take here.
Marshman should go to the body. He should throw a straight right or a left hook to the body or an uppercut or something. When he leans forward like that, soccer kick into the face or hit him in the body. Oh, Jim Manning is not going to do it. He should go to the body. This fight is almost over.
If it stays like this, Steph, I think this is the final moments for Carl Noon. I don't think he can get back up. I don't think Mark Woodard would let him continue much like this anymore.
Uppercuts under the armpit is what he should be throwing here to catch the chin. Oh, going for... No, he's not going to go for the choke. Noon almost does a rollover.
There's still plenty of time left in this round. And it's been a complete turnaround of fortune. But I think, like yourself, Marshman, there's been two opportunities there that he could have been finished by now.
Yeah, I think that Marshman might want to think about just standing back up, because to try and do a ground and pound victory here, he's going to basically be in close and it's going to be hard to land a devastating punch. Now he's got mount. He hasn't thrown a lot of elbows, but he should throw. There we go. Can you hear me, Mr. Marshman?
The fight professor calls it again, and they start to land now. And Mark Woodard will be looking very closely at this.
There it is. There it is. The first ever British BAMMA middleweight champion, Jack Marshman, has done it here in the third round.
But he had to come through a wall of attrition to do it, Stephen.
Man, that first round was brutal. I thought maybe if that eye was closing, they may have had to stop the fight, but it didn't work out that way. Turned things around in the second and lowered the boom here in the third. And Noon tried his best, but his body betrayed him.
Yeah, you can't fault his courage here, Stephen. But as you said, there was nothing there to back it up. Sheer guts and determination, but there was no way he could take much more of this.
Yeah, I think it's going to be a situation where Noon is going to go back and watch this, get on the treadmill. Nothing to be ashamed of. He fought his heart out. But that man there, Jack the Hammer Marshman, takes care of business.
As you said, you had a feeling Noon early or Marshman late because of that size, that age difference, that muscularity. And it proved to be exactly that. All Noon to start, but Marshman just would not give in.
That was a great fight. That fight delivered. Okay, what a performance. People are going to definitely remember this fight. I'll tell you what. I'll tell you what, I think these guys are going to meet each other again in the future.
Ladies and gentlemen, how about a big round of applause? That was a fight for the ages. Unbelievable. Ladies and gentlemen, referee Mark Woodard has called a stop to this fight at 2:09 of the third round, declaring the winner by TKO and new Lonsdale British champion, Jack Hammer Marshman.
An unbelievable fight down here at BAMMA 7, live and exclusive on Sci-Fi. Jack, I think the first question is, how does it feel to be the new British middleweight champion?
It's unreal, man. It's such an unbelievable feeling. BAMMA's the biggest organisation in Europe at the minute, and I wanted to be the British champion for it.
It seemed towards the end it was going to be the man who wanted it more, and it seemed like you wanted it because Carl was out on his feet, and he looked with your eye as well. You just had to keep going.
I'll fight to the death, man. You know what I mean? Whoever they put in the cage with me, very prepared to die for, well, they want to take this off me, you know what I mean?
Well, you've got it round your waist right now, and obviously you're still a serving soldier. We're being streamed on BFBS tonight as well. Obviously, a lot of soldiers, people in the forces around the world have been cheering you on.
Yeah, you know, big shout out to the Parachute Regiment charity and my regiment that let me give me time off to do this. Thanks a lot to 3-Para.
Well, listen, I think right now is the time that you get to take a little break and a sit down. And remember that you are the Lonsdale British middleweight champion. Put your hands together for Jack Marshman!